Alright, welcome back to another stream. Alright. Refreshing my page. Lower the fan here. Alright. Hopefully everything's going good. Throat's a little... Yeah. Throat's a little shitty right now. I'm gonna plug in my computer very quick. Alright. Now that that's taken care of. Alright. Oops. Turning off my computer sound. Alright, so that there's no echo. Sorry about that. So yeah, let's see, where the fuck do I go? I know there's some kind of boss. Got myself the chocobo. I save stated last night, so I'm able to just ride the fucking chocobo around. Where do I fucking take this prick? I know there's some kind of marsh. Wasn't it somewhere like around here? I think so. I think I'm supposed to be around. Yep. Oh! Shit! Okay. Well, this is happening. I'm already dead? Okay. Alrighty then. I am going to have to heal, like, now. Your clouds, dumbass. Limit cross slasher. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to have someone on cure every 5 seconds. I'm on, bruh. And really, in the end, Cloud and Tifa are really what matter, but still, beat all three of them. Fuck you. Oh my god, so thank god for Cloud's all materia. Oh shit. He should probably be my, like, go-to, like, white mage. But it doesn't work all the time, see, so... Shit. Yeah, I need to cure Cloud again. He took Cloud out of battle! No! Oh shit. Oh shit. He's using it again! Okay, I guess that was it! Look at what helps me actually get past that fucker. I guess he caught up with me. I didn't see the shadow get at me though. I saw it this time coming after me, but not the first time. Sephiroth do this? So there were two of those pricks? Oh my god. The only reason why I'm not blacked out is because Cloud got kicked out of the fucking battle. Okay, well, guess we'll be using some Phoenix Downs.
You got the downs.
Alright, well, that's all good and dandy then. Let's just check out a few things. Alright. I guess that's it. It was just supposed to, you know, because I walked by. No, motherfucker. Of course it runs. I guess I... Oh, okay. Ah, there's a path. I see. I'll be able to get Yuffie. I looked up how to get her just in case, but I know she's a missable character. Same goes with Vincent Valentine. I don't think Vincent Valentine's anywhere until like the second disc or something like that, so. Yeah. But I don't want to miss any characters. I would like to get all of them. Man, just beat the crap out of it. Yep. Da 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 da. Leveled up. Got me my money too, bitch. Yeah, cause, you know, that's worth it. Whatever. What's up here? Oh, that would be. Hold up. Hold up. Can I get that to, Yeah, that would be good for him. That would have been useful when I was on the elevator boss. This freaking, Big Red kept, you know, saying, can't reach. So his moves just were, like, basically screwed until he had his limit. Up with Cloud. Probably got affected with something. Fury, sadness, whatever the fuck. Biohazard, your balls. He was almost out of MP too, though. Oh shit, that was a lot of damage, okay. Well, Cloud apparently sucked using Blade. Ah, it must be whatever he's using. Is it Darkness that's on him? Probably Darkness. Not easy to hit. I'm probably better off just using magic then at this in this case. Blade beam. Is that a new limit for Cloud?
Okay. Go ahead and use some cure.
Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna need anything. Let's see, how much is me? Not the worst, but not the best. Eh, whatever, everyone leveled up anyway. If I keep getting 300 XP like that, then shoot. By all means. As long as I don't die anyway. Die over the bullshit. Oh, I can't go any higher. Don't know why, it looks like I'm able to go there, but apparently not. Behind attack, really? Alright, since I can't hit them with normal attacks very easily, I just use magic. When it's my turn. Hey look, Big Red has 666 health! That's a good sign. I hit myself. Oh my god. Why is that allowed? Why are you able to do that? You shouldn't be allowed to do that. AP. I'm just running the notice. It says next to next level 884p, or next like next level. So, what does that mean? I hope I never see you again. You know who I am? From the Turks, right? Well, if you know, then this won't take long. It's difficult to explain what the Turks do. Kidnapping, right? Well, if you put it negatively, you could say that. But that's not all there is to it anymore. Rude. Rude. Say rude. Sir! The fuck is your problem? Alright, Rude, I know you don't like speeches, so don't force it. And Elena, you explain. I'm the newest member of the Turks, Elena. Thanks to what you did to Reno, we're short of people. What did I do to Reno? Because I kicked his ass a little bit? Oh, because of that, I got promoted to the Turks. In any case, our job is to find out where Sephiroth is headed. And to try and stop you every step of the way. Wait a minute. It's the other way around. You're the ones that are getting in our way. You talk too much. No need to tell them about our orders. Sorry, Sang. I thought I gave you other orders. Don't forget. Oh, now go. Don't forget to file the report. Alright. Very well. Rude and I will go after Sephiroth, who's headed for Dunan Harbor. Elena, you don't seem to understand. Oh, shit. I'm sorry. I told them the plans. Reno said he wanted to see you after the injuries you gave him healed. He wants to show his affection for you all with a new weapon. Uh-oh. We're in trouble. Something's going on to burst our bubbles. Where's Aerith? She's not with you. Aerith isn't with us. She's with the others. On. Give her my regards. Oh, does that mean if I had Aerith with me, she would have said something? Or he would have said something to her? Interesting. Yeah, Banjo Dicks! Kill them all, killing, killing, just to blow them away. dun, da, da. You got the downs. Alright, so I didn't even notice how much XP that was. Didn't pay attention, actually. New item. Need elixir. Good shit. High potion. Good shit. My stream for me has seemed to froze, so I don't know if anyone's in the actual room or chatting at all, because my stream apparently froze on me, so reloading that now because I just realized it. So if anyone was already trying to chat to me or whatever, I apologize for nothing ever coming up. Oh, hey, Wolves, what's up? Welcome to the chat. I know I can get Yuffie, like, right here. In the woods up ahead, so I'm gonna try to get Yuffie. Shit. Oh yeah? Was it like the fourth guy in the second stage or something like that? I know there's a lot of hard people in Initial D. That game is not easy. Go get myself Yuffie. I can change my PHS right now, right? Let's see. Maybe I should get Barret for this one. The guy you quit in your part 5 video. Oh yeah, him. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I know who you're talking about. Yeah, that fucker ain't easy. The game takes skill. Initial D, it's a very rewarding game though, because it's not like, oh, they're unfair. It's legitimately about skill. You need to know how to actually drive. Not like driving real life, obviously, but you gotta have some skill in playing the game. Barret. Using damn, what the fuck? These are bricks. No, I didn't want to use this freaking limit. Oh well. Yeah, should probably heal myself. There, how could you? Getting beat by a bunch of random monsters is the saddest thing in the world. They do a shit ton of damage though! Shit, man, what the hell? Okay, there's no going easy, man. Oh yeah, the two girls, they're hard, but I like them. They're a fun race. All the races are pretty much fun, even the ones that get really fucking hard. Like the two girls are when it like starts to really get challenging. Oh, better use freaking Phoenix down. Right? I better like... I can't take the... the materials off of them, can I? I have to. I'm pretty sure Eris has my other restore. The only reason why I'm using her right now to get the freaking restore back. Actually, you don't have it. Okay, oh, Tifa. Duh. Maybe I should just have Tifa with me. Let's just have Tifa. Come on, Yuffie. In fact, save the game. Save the game, I don't want to lose. Be right back, grabbing something to eat. Alright, Wolves. See you when you get back. My limit for Yuffie, that'd be awesome. So hopefully by like the next battle, Yuffie will be around. Get away from me. He's so tiny. He's like a fruit fly. There ain't no fruit in here, bitch. Okay, I should use cure. Yeah, use cure. Yuffie! You shall be mine! Die, the fuck you! You're right on my screen, okay? I'm gonna kill you! Oh, come on! You're being a dick! Fuck this! You're fucking pissing me off! It's like right in my face! Everyone's got their limits. Just freaking save me from my torment. Yuffie, I want your bum. Let's see. Heal myself again. Oh, hey, Shock Factor, what's up? You know what? No, fuck this battle. I ain't. No. Run, you fucks. Run! Oh my god. Those little bastards are monstrous. Yeah, no problem, man. Yeah, Kids Cartoon on .com, .me or whatever is really fucking awesome. It buffers hella quick and everything. I love that site. Gotta keep using fucking Cure, man. Again, I'll be saving. Don't wanna lose anything. I just realized I didn't eat anything today. I didn't eat anything at all. And I just realized it's because my stomach's fucking with me. By the way, you have to chat? Yeah, sure. Let's see, going on Skype. What's up, Wolves? Welcome back. Alright, there we go. What's up, man?
Hello.
Welcome to the stream.
Hello, one other person in the chat.
Random motherfucker joining in.
Shock Factor joins the battle.
And who the fuck is Shock Factor? he's nobody.
Hey, what's up, dude?
Nothing much.
Fuck you.
Just doing a random stream. Like, I was my plan was to do, like, streams on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Like, I even have a schedule on my thing. But I was just in the mood today, so I was like, fuck it.
Can't speak English. Yep. Again, thanks for the site, dude. It's really fucking cool.
No problem at all, dude. Like I said, that fucking thing is awesome. Like, I forgot how I found it. I found it, I think because of Big Hero 6. Someone linked it on Facebook, and that's when I first, actually saw it. And I just stuck with it.
Wait, that site has movies?
Yeah, it has movies. Animated movies.
That site has movies, dude?
Yeah, it even has the fucking, some live-action movies, too, like, Alvin and the Chipmunks, you know, those shitty movies and crap. Yep. So many fucking movies and shows. The only thing I don't like about it is it doesn't keep the movies separated from the shows. But, you know, if you look through the list, they're all there. Why can I not find fucking Yuffie?
Yeah, I was wrong about, because you know how I said they had the episodes out of order? I was wrong. It was the seasons that.
Yeah, the seasons are not connected. They're separate.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only thing about this site, that they keep everything separate. But in a way, it's still organized. At least you can still find everything.
Man, I said, I've been having a lot of fun watching Beast Wars.
Yeah, I need to watch that. It's been like a year and a half since I saw that show.
Yeah, you did say you were planning on reviewing that, right?
Well, I said it's a possibility. Well, like, when you asked me, it's always possible. I was thinking about it the other day.
Well, what's called, if you ever need somebody to help do it with you, you know, I'm always here.
Yeah, for sure.
Because I'm starting to, I'm starting to get into it.
Yeah, it's like right now I'm doing, like, the My Little Pony reviews. I'm working on those. So once I'm done with that show, then I'll be all fucking set for whatever comes next. I need to finish the rest of Gravity Falls. I'm so sick.
I was about
sick.
To say, please, for the love of God, make it stop.
Yeah, and then fucking season 5 comes out on April 4th. It never ends. So far, though, season 4 is actually pretty, not impressive. That'll give it too much credit. But it's the best season so far. The animation's a lot better. There's better lighting. Better episodes. So it's still starting to actually, you know, grow on me. At least that one.
What, Gravity Falls?
No. Season 4 of My Little Pony.
Ugh.
Yeah, trust me. I am not, in love with the show at all. But I do see, I can see why some people actually like it. But Season 4, definitely for me so far, only 3 episodes in, and it's actually one of the better seasons.
Huh.
Already. You know, the Cutie Mark Crusaders? The 3 little fucking kid ponies?
I don't watch the show, so.
Okay, well,
know.
Those characters annoy the ever-living shit out of me. The only time I ever like them is when there's an episode where they're separated and they're like, you know, they're doing their own thing. The last episode I just saw was one of their episodes. And it was actually probably my favorite one out of all their episodes. It was actually pretty fucking good, surprisingly. Because it wasn't about them getting their fucking cutie marks. God, that's the worst part about their episodes. It's the same shit.
Like I said, I don't know too much about that show, so I don't really have it.
Yeah, it's a show that I was like, why do people watch it, blah, 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 you know? I was probably considered one of the haters, just because, oh, bronies, grown man, that's fucking, you know, it's like, let's hate the show. But then I kind of see, like, things, it's kind of sad, because I'm usually an open-minded person. So it's like, me judging like that was pretty out of character for me. So I kind of decided, okay, I'll give it a chance, especially after the Equestria fucking movie. God damn that movie. No matter, even after watching the season, that movie is still terrible. I am dying here. So I decided to watch it. First season, the best I can sum it up is meh. It's very boring. Season 2 was better.
That's a lot.
Season 3 sucks.
Well, that's really a lot of shows in general. A lot of shows are just meh nowadays.
Yeah.
No TV shows hold the luster that, you know, but then again, I guess you can also count that as nostalgia, I guess, like, because you look back at the older shows that you liked so fondly, like, for example, Beast Wars.
Yeah.
That still holds up really well. Well, the animation doesn't.
The animation sucks, but like I said, if you can watch it, you'll notice, like, after each season, the graphics do improve little by little each season. Third season, by far, is the best-looking one.
So Beast Machines, like, I'm sorry, Beast Machines did not look that good. I'm sorry.
The animation, you can tell it's improved, but yeah, it's very bland, to say the least. And why the fuck is Yuffie not coming to me? Do I need something to get Yuffie? What the fuck?
I don't know. I don't friggin' play Final Fantasy VII. I think it's overrated, so.
Well, I could probably agree with that, too, but shit. The least it can do is give me my fucking character.
But like I said, because something, if you notice with like all the Transformers shows in general, they kind of gave you a tutorial on how to transform the toy, even Beast Wars. Beast Machines did not do that at all.
Yeah, because they just have an animation that like they just turn, like, you know, the body just shifts a little bit and boom, they're transformed.
Not just that, but with Beast Machines, the bodies morph. Like they pop, it doesn't transform naturally like what you would think of with like any other Transformers series.
Yeah, like for me, probably the weirdest looking character in that show was fucking the Bat. That fucking character looks weird as shit.
I think that's
probably his name.
I'll take a look right now.
Like, he looks like an emo kind of character.
Yeah,
like he just doesn't look right. See, what the fuck? Yuffie is available immediately in the first forest you see in the game. You need to get out of Midgar, go to Chocobo Farm, blah, 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 then go through the cave. Out of the cave, you are located in Gondivore, to the right of the part of the forest, where you can see you get Yuffie, blah, blah, blah. Sorry, I'm looking up.
By the way, it's cool. It's Night Scream, by the way.
That's not. Oh, okay. All right, then there you go. That's his name. I did not remember that.
Yay!
Fucking Christ.
Yeah, well, then again, a blind squirrel gets a nut every once in a while, so.
Yep. I'm not really good at remembering names. I'm more of a faces guy.
Well, with me, I am more like names. Like, I can give a name to a Transformer or anything like that.
Yeah, for me, I probably know the original names: Optimus Prime, Megatron, Starscream. What's his fucking name? I know Cheetah, or whatever from fucking
Cheetor.
Yeah, I know him.
Yeah.
I know Ratface. No.
Rat Trap.
Yeah. I just like calling him Ratface. I like calling everything that's a rat and is like a humanoid character Ratface. I called a real person in real life Ratface. I feel sorry.
It's Which one? He looks fucking weird in a Beast Machines rat trap.
Yeah, he looks a little weird, but his design kind of grows on you, though.
What's called,
Oh, wait, in Beast Machines. Beast Machines. No, never mind. Yeah, Beast Machines, he looks weird. Beast Wars, he grows on you.
Yeah, I like the look of Beast Wars, because it looks, you know, like... You can see that he looks rat-like. Like, when you look at him closely, you see the appearance of a rat in his regular form.
Yeah.
But in Beast Machines, he looks like a regular human. Like, that's all that the Predacons and Maximals in general. A lot of them look just like humans. The only one that kept their regular appearance was Megatron.
Yep.
But everyone else just kind of was like, meh.
Like the spider character. I forgot, which one? There's
Arachnia.
Black Arachnia, isn't that the girl one or the science one?
Yeah, the Black Arachnia is the girl one. Tarantulas is the guy.
Yeah, he goes all the way up to season 3. That fucker's he's bad news.
And then of course he gets promptly roasted.
Yep. Gotta like the episode where I forgot their names. The White Tiger Transformer and the Girl Hawk, or whatever they mix.
Tigatron and Air Razor, they become Tiger Hawk.
Yeah. What sucks is the way he goes, the way he sacrifices himself seems so anticlimactic, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it just happens.
Yeah, that show had its moments where it was really good, and then it had its moments where it was like, this is so fucking stupid.
Because it kind of just felt like it was a little rushed, because it was the finale around that point, so... Who knows?
Yeah. Well, then again, I think that was because at that point they were trying to push Beast Machines. Because Beast Machines was supposed to come out, in the next couple months.
Yeah, so it was, right after that.
So it was oh shit, gotta ramp it up. Rush, 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 rush.
Like, what happened after Beast Wars? So, yeah, we're now in freaking, what's their planet called? And Megatron's a dick. Cybertron. And now everyone's fucking bland looking and all that shit. Which is always great, right?
Optimus Primal looks fucking nothing like even Optimus Primal in Beast Wars, when you look at him, you think he looks like Optimus Prime. With Beast Machines, it's like, the hell is this?
Yeah, Beast Machines is a very odd one. Definitely isn't as good with writing, the animation, which is sad considering, it could have been a big improvement, but I'd rather have something that looks crappy but has an identity than something that looks bland and nothing else. Uh-oh, got someone else calling. Johnny, I'm talking. Alright, I'll let him know that I'm already in a chat.
Well, what's called? You can add him, that's fine.
Sure, alright.
Yeah, if you want to have a three-way, that's fine.
I don't want a three-way of any kind.
You know what I mean.
No, you piece of shit. No, I did not. What's up, Johnny?
Sounds about right.
By the way, I finally found fucking Yuffie's dumbass. That took forever.
Yay.
So what's up, Johnny?
I'm not much. Just got off work.
Oh, yeah?
Hello.
Aren't you gonna go to fucking sleep or something?
No. Well, I've been up since 1 morning, so...
Oh, shit. Yeah, it's already 12 o'clock for you.
It's not that bad.
It's 3 p.m. for me.
Yeah, well, he lives in, whatchamacallit, California.
Ew.
Yeah, he works night shift, so that's why he's he was up since 1 o'clock.
No, I work early in the morning.
Early. Oh, so you, okay, you've been okay. So you just been up since 1.
Well, what's called to me to classify midnight shift, that'd be 12 midnight to 6 a.m.
Yep. If I get a job, I hope it's night shift or something like that, because I'm not a morning person, not at fucking all.
I had to become a morning person.
With me, I can do either morning or night, but it takes a lot of, It really depends on what day it is. Like, Monday, it's like, I can sleep in. You know, like, you know, can I just be late? You know? Can I be, like, an hour and a half late or so?
Oh, no! Yuffie! I was gonna save so I didn't lose her! No! 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 You bitch! You left!
What did you do?
Oh! The bitch left! She took 200... took 200 of my gold. I should have approached her first. Fuck! I thought I could save. That save point was a fucking... It was bait! It was bait, and fuck you! Fuck you, game! I don't care that she stole 200 of my money. I don't give a fuck! I better be able to get her back. Fuck that bitch! See, this is why I save. This is why I save.
And this is why Final Fantasy VII sucks. You can't get Yuffie.
Oh, is that, like, did she straight up leave? Like, is that how this works? Because if it is, fuck you. I'm gonna turn it off. I'm restarting it. Reset. Nope. Screw you. Screw you. You stupid bitch. Wasted fucking like 5 to 10 minutes of my life. I finally find her, and then she fucks me. God damn it. Fuck that save point. I wish it wasn't there.
Oh, that is too funny.
I thought it was there so that I could save in case she tried to pull anything, but of course it's there so that she could pull something. In fact, you can't even save at it. It is literally, it's literally a beginner's trap. Fuck. Fuck you then, stupid bitch.
It's funny, because you know she's like one of the better characters you can get, right?
I don't know anything about her, like, stats or anything. I don't know how strong she is or whatever, if she's even worth using in battle. I just want her for, like, just to have the full party.
Which one? I think she's the most... Which one? I think she's one of the characters that, like, has a lot less avoiding or whatever. Well, wait, what level is Cloud in your game?
17. So she'll be like 18 or something like that, I'm sure.
No, her level would be 17 as well. Because Cloud's level is 1 through 20, Yuffie would be 17.
Ah, okay, I see. Because I thought she was like always a level higher.
So if she's above 10, she would normally... Well, she would have about, let me see, she would have 343 HP, 64 to 68 MP, 17 to 24 strength, 13 to 20 dexterity, English.
English, motherfucker, do you speak it?
Speak it. 15 to 22 vitality, 18 to 25 magic, 15 to 22 spirit, and 16 to 22 luck. I think she's one of the luckier characters in the game, I think.
Where things miss her a lot and shit like that?
Huh?
Like, where things miss her a lot and shit like that and is able, like, to be immune to certain things?
No, luck in games is, like, a higher chance of getting a critical strike. Like, doing critical damage.
Alright, that's cool. Yeah, I don't know if I've ever really done any critical. I think I did like maybe one critical hit with Cloud in this entire playthrough.
Huh.
Besides like the limit forms, obviously. I don't know how much those get, but yeah, normal attacks, I don't think I've been doing that many critical hits.
Yeah, I want to tell a little interesting fact, just looking at the Final Fantasy Wiki here. Yuffie is the only party member to be fought against.
Oh yeah, that is true. I'm pretty sure, like, because Vincent is, like, the only one, the only other one that's, you know, an optional character. But I don't think he fights you. You have to have to fight a boss to get to him, but I don't think that he's an enemy.
Yeah. But then again, like I said, I don't really know all too much about this stuff, so... I mean, I know my fair share, but, you know, not to the extent.
Yeah, I don't know jack shit about this game. Even Final Fantasy IX, I beat that game, and I don't really know a whole lot about it anymore. It's been like 4 or 5 years since I actually played it. Fucking
yeah. Well, with me, the last Final Fantasy game I played, I think was either 10-2 or 11, somewhere in that range. But then after that, it was just kind of, eh.
I thought 12 was pretty good. I like the battle system for that. It felt more like an action RPG.
Yeah.
Plus, you were also able to see the enemy, so it got rid of the random battle bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Which was really nice for me. Because it was at a time where I was, like, really tired of random battles. Because I played a lot of Golden Sun, Pokemon, Final Fantasy, a lot of shit that had random battles, and it just kind of just dragged on you. Dragon Quest, etc.
Oh my god, Golden Sun? Really?
Golden Sun's That's fucking old. Awesome. That shit was awesome, though. I never beat the third one, though, for awesome. DS. I own it, but I've never beaten it. Which is sad, considering I am a pretty good fan of Golden Sun. I mean, I beat the first two, like, probably 3 times each.
Yeah, which one? I have my PS2 set up. I'm just gonna play some DBZ Budokai 3. Yes, I still own it.
Yeah, I own Budokai 3 and Budokai 1 and Tenkaichi 2.
Yeah, which one? I think 3 is the rarest Dragon Ball Z game now, ain't it?
Budokai 3?
Yeah, considering all the controversy that happened with the... Let's call it with the musical artist or whatever.
Oh yeah, I suppose it is then. Because in the HD edition, they changed the music and everything, which... Yeah, blow me. The music in the game is fucking awesome. Take that away, then screw you.
Yeah, the music was one of the better aspects for DBZ.
For sure, all the rock music and everything. That's one thing that really brings Kai down. The music just is not as good. They have like a Western style shit going on, and it doesn't mix.
Yeah. With me, when I think of Dragon Ball Z, I think very much of just, you know, like, ass-kicking, and when I think of ass-kicking, I think of hard rock, so.
Yeah, like, the music really go with the mood, like, when Goku, like, turns into a Super Saiyan, that the music that goes with it is so fucking awesome, I get chills every fucking time I see that scene. Every fucking time, I get chills. Have the Kai music, it doesn't do it.
Yeah, it's very, what you call it? Very anticlimactic.
Yep. It's like, oh yeah, Goku. The most awesome part is when he first turns into a Super Saiyan. Have the wrong music, you fuck it all up.
Well, then again, Sonic X, in the Japanese dub, they used Live and Learn when,
Yeah, Live and Learn's a fucking drastic. Cool. That's a cool, song.
Yeah, well, don't expect to see it in the 4 Kids dub, because it didn't show up in it.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. That's why 4 Kids sucks. Oh my god, Yuffie, I will fucking shove my freaking foot up your ass and pussy if you do not pop the fuck out right now.
Damn.
I am so irritated with this bitch, dude. I had her! I fucking had her! She was mine! Damn me!
You know what you call it? You shouldn't sound like that with a character who's what? Yuffie's like, what's supposed to be, 13, 14 years old?
Wasn't that in Crisis Core? I think she's like... Oh, wait, she's still a minor in this one. She's probably at least 16, 17. Okay, did not think about that. Like I said, I don't know shit about this game. Forgive me, but I will shove my fucking foot up her ass. I don't give a fuck what age she is. I will beat a minor. Like, don't you disrespect me, bitch. Still my money.
Oh, God.
You ain't going to juvie, motherfucker.
You're going to the House of Pain.
The House of Pain. God damn it. Yeah, I think she's like 13 or whatever in Crisis Core. And then like, I think in this one she's like 16 or 17 now that I think about it.
What the hell is wrong with all of us?
I don't know. I'm a very sadistic prick. Oh, you're in pain? I'll laugh about it. Like, okay. Not to bring My Little Pony up again, but whenever Rarity, the one that's all white and all about like her looks and shit, every time she cries, I can't help but laugh about it. I love when she's in pain or like in despair or something. Like, it's so fucking hilarious for me. I don't know why. It's not like I hate her. She's not a bad character. It's just funny seeing her cry.
evil motherfucker.
It's like, fuck that bitch.
Evil!
Evil! Or SpongeBob. Bald! Bald! Bald!
My eyes!
What's funny about that scene is all the fish that are like yelling bald are all bald as well. Like, they're all bald. None of them have hair.
Yeah, none of them have hair.
Like, they're ones to talk. SpongeBob doesn't even have any fucking hair. What the shit? Bald. Joke just made for that one guy for that one scene.
Yeah, which Wolves, actually...
Wolves loves the new Dragon Ball Z remastered episodes in HD. Wait, so they actually, remade the actual episodes in HD, or is it just, like, the Kai series? Because I'm not a big fan of the Kai series. I know they did Dragon Ball Kai now. Aren't they, like, remaking the Dragon Ball series?
I'm not certain.
Because I saw something called Dragon Ball Kai, not Dragon Ball Z Kai. So...
Well, then again, we know what happened the last time they tried to make something new. We got Dragon Ball GT.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, gee.
Yeah. Like, look, I like the characters for the most part. Like, the Super Saiyan 4 stuff I can deal with. I don't like Baby. Fuck Baby. Probably the worst character in that entire thing. The reason why GT sucks overall is because they made Goku seem like he's the best out of everyone, and everyone else just suddenly sucks. Like, why didn't Trunks and Goten fuse at all in that series? They never explain why. Don't give me that crap that their power levels are different. Don't fucking give me that shit. They never brought that up either.
Yeah.
So that's a bunch of shit.
They almost had, who was it? Gohan and Goku fuse?
That's in Dragon Ball Z. Yeah. That's in Buu Saga.
I know, but I was bringing that up as a reminder, even though their power levels are nowhere near alike, even at that point.
Yeah, even when freaking Gohan was Mystic Gohan. Mystic Gohan at that point became stronger than Super Saiyan 3 Goku, so how the fuck... Oh, wait, at the same time, though, I don't think that matters, because it was the fusion with the earrings, not the fusion like Goten and Trunks used. Which, that's the one you have to be at the same... Yeah, that's the one you have to be the same power level. With the earrings, I don't think it worked that way.
The earrings, it didn't really matter.
Yeah, I think it just fused anyone. So, like, basically... Like, Goku was gonna go fucking fuse with Hercule. Like, what the fuck in the hell was that gonna be?
Fuck if I know.
Yeah, well, DBZ is the best version of out of all of them, except at the same time, it is very dragged on. Like, the Frieza fight goes for, like, ever.
Yeah,
5 minutes until,
like,
Namek blows up.
Episodes?
20 minutes later. I mean, 20 episodes later. Get the fuck out of here with that.
Unless, of course, they were fighting at light speed, which, you know.
Yeah,
I don't believe that shit one bit, but...
Yeah, it's like, Frieza, do you even know how to count? Like, 5 minutes, 20 episodes, bruh.
15 minutes per episode.
I think it was like 20 minutes per episode.
I'm trying to think. Yeah, I think.
Like 20, 23 minutes.
Yeah, somewhere in that range.
Because, like, usually 7 minutes is usually worth, or out of, like, commercials. So, yeah.
And what's called? We already have a new DBZ movie.
Yeah, I know. Revival of F. They better have a good reason for bringing Frieza back. Which, yeah, I saw the comic, just for the revival of Frieza. Yeah, it's not a bad comic, but yeah.
did they ever explain why that was?
They wish Frieza back. Okay, like they have their
What?
Now, hear me out. They use the Dragon Balls, the human Dragon Balls from Earth, right? Which I'm pretty sure they can revive anyone who's, you know, even if they've been dead for a while, right? So, because the Namek ones are the only ones that cannot revive, I think, after a year. So you have the Earth Dragon Balls.
Yeah.
You want to know why Pilaf is back in the movie? They were completely pointless in the first one, but they're bringing them back because they're the ones who give the freaking Dragon Balls or get the Dragon Balls for Frieza's army or whatever the fuck. And, so...
Oh, fuck's sake.
Yep, so they... Okay, they wish Frieza back, and the dragon says, yeah, I could bring him back, but he's in pieces because of what Trunks did to him, so he's in fucking pieces. And so the guy...
He can still be in pieces.
Yeah, he's in pieces. Basically, his robotic body and all that shit, he's in straight up pieces. So what ends up happening is, whatchamacallit, so the guy wishes Frieza back anyway, and he's in pieces. They grab him, and they take him because they have the new regeneration, so they can fix him completely back to his at normal form, no robotic pieces or anything. So that's how Frieza gets back, completely back to normal, etc. They revive him, but Frieza is even weaker than before. He says ever since he died, his body got weaker. So okay, because that's believable. What's not believable is, at this point, Frieza's like, so how strong has everyone gotten, right? And, they explain how Goku is, you know, he beat Majin Buu and all that bullshit. And Frieza says, wow, like, the only people that my father ever said to never mess with was Beerus, the God of Destruction, and, Majin Buu. And so, considering now...
Wait a fucking minute here.
Yeah.
Didn't he see Goku kill Majin Buu?
I think he saw a fight with Majin Buu. But if you remember, most of the battle was cut off at a certain point, I think. So not everyone was able to see the actual climax of what actually happened.
But, I mean, he would have at least seen Majin Buu fighting Goku.
Yeah, I think they saw that much, but I don't think they saw the entire fight, so... So it is news to Frieza that Goku actually beat Majin Buu. So with that said, Frieza says that in 4 months' time, he could get stronger. Why? Because he never actually practiced. He never trained ever. He was always just as strong as he was because of who he was. So he never actually trained.
Base level.
Yeah, no, not even just base level. Even at full power, he never trained. So since we know nothing about Frieza's race, I can kind of buy that if he did train, like, intentionally try to pass Goku, that it could happen. Because we know nothing about Frieza's race if you really think about it. We don't know how strong they can really get when they try. So, with that said, Frieza says in 4 months' time, he could surpass Goku at the strength that he is now. Which, okay, Goku got stronger because of God form. Let's remember that. So, and I don't know if Frieza actually knows about that. So with that said, if Frieza can really get that strong in 4 fucking months, they really, really have to spoon feed me the information and make it really worth my while and make it really believable, because I'm buying it, but only as far as him getting stronger than the part where Goku beat Majin Buu. I don't buy that he'll get as strong as Super Saiyan, Goku in his base form after using Super Saiyan God. So they better have a good excuse for that shit.
What's called? Didn't they also say in the original DBZ that Kaioken was stronger, but it did a lot more damage to the body than going just flat Super Saiyan did? Because I remember hearing something that, like, if you go Kaioken, like, you're still incredibly strong, but it only works, like, you're stronger than, like, maybe base Super Saiyan, but you can't hold it for a longer time.
It depends on how many times the Kaioken goes. Like, if we remember, Kaioken was only used once again after the Frieza saga, which was, I think, after the Buu saga, when Goku goes back to I forgot what it was. It's where he fights that other dude that looks like Piccolo and shit like that. And Goku went into Piccolo, yeah, or whatever. And he turned into Super Saiyan 2 or whatever. And he used Kaioken times 20 at the same time as using Super Saiyan 2. So I can imagine that being strong as hell. But that's the only other time that we ever saw Kaioken again. So. Yeah, I don't really know how much information we actually have on that, but yeah, from what I know, it does do more damage to the body, but I think if you're experienced enough, like Goku is with Super Saiyan 2 and all that kind of shit, I mean, he was able to turn to Super Saiyan 3, but at that point, he wanted to go easy on everyone else, so he turned to Super Saiyan 2 instead of Super Saiyan 3 and used Kaioken times 20. So I'm pretty sure he can handle it at that point, because we never saw him use 20 before.
But I'm wanting to know how much higher it goes. Like, is 20 the maximum, or is there, like, a times 50, or, you know, times 100, or anything like that?
I don't think it really has a limit. I guess it depends on how strong the actual person is, and how, you know, and if their body can handle it.
Yeah, if their body can take that beating.
Yeah, because remember, Kaioken times 4 was the limit for Goku back when he fought Vegeta. That was surpassed his limit. So, considering that he was able to surpass it in a way, I think there really is no limit. It just depends on the person.
Huh. Yeah, it's what you call it. It's very much.
Can you believe this bitch still hasn't shown up? I'm still at this. I've been recording for a fucking hour! I've been at this for fucking 40 minutes! Fuck's sake, I got to this part in 20 minutes during the live stream. I've been trying to get this bitch for 40 minutes. This is like just, oh my god, dude. I fucked up. Next time I find her, I am fucking saving state, dude. That's what I should have done.
Hey.
It should not take this long to find this bitch.
Well, that would also be the logical thing to do.
Yep.
You know what you should have done in the first place?
Yeah, the thing is, like, here's the thing. When the video that I saw where the guy gets Yuffie, he says, watch out for Yuffie, like, how you approach her, but he never said that if you go to your save point or whatever, you get fucked. He just straight up went to Yuffie and said that and you know, gave no other information. So I thought when I saw the save point, hey, I could save in case I fuck something up, and then I can get Yuffie. But yeah, it was a fucking beginner's trap, of course, so.
Was the ultimate spit in the face, and you fell for it.
Yep, I really fucking did. I should have just fucking approached Yuffie, goddammit.
Like a right twit.
And really, there was no point in me fucking, like, not doing it, because I have the questions and the way you're supposed to answer, or not the questions, but the, like, okay, when you reply to Yuffie what she says, I have the right order to say them, so I can get her.
Uh-huh.
I should have just went along with it, but, you know, being the fucking asshole I am, I didn't.
Nah.
Nah. God damn it, Yuffie. Seriously, like, the fucking guy found Yuffie on his video after like two battles. It's ridiculous.
Well, remember, he ain't you.
Random number generated bullshit.
That's RPGs in a nutshell, dude.
Exactly. Is exactly my issue.
And that's the reason why the only RPG I actually play is friggin' Pokemon.
Yeah, Pokemon's like, I haven't played Pokemon in forever. What would make me go back to Pokemon is playing the Pokemon Alpha Sapphire.
Alpha Ruby. No, it's Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire.
Yeah, Alpha Sapphire is what I would like to play. Considering Sapphire is one of my favorite versions.
I wish they made an Emerald version.
Yeah, I don't think they're gonna do that though. I mean, if you look at it, like, they never did a remake of Crystal version, which we all know was the superior version out of the two.
Yeah. Well, wait, Gold and Crystal was Gen 2, right?
Yeah. Gold and Silver were the base versions, like kind of like a Red and Blue version were for us, and then Yellow was the superior one, and Crystal was the superior one to the Gold and Silver franchise.
Huh.
But the only thing that made Crystal special pretty much was that you had the dogs, obviously, and the Pokemon icons moved.
That was it.
Pretty much. And I think we get all of that in the remakes of Heart and Silver, right? So,
yeah, Heart Gold and Soul Silver.
Yeah, and aren't we able to get the dogs too in those versions?
I'm trying to remember, actually.
Because I never beat Heart Gold. It got stolen from me. Like, fucking, god damn it. Yeah, I had a big problem with thieves. Yeah, people were assholes. And they claim to be your friend until they steal shit behind your back. Fuck them motherfuckers.
Hey, fuck the fucking fuckers.
Just like fucking you for here, stupid cunt. Fucking show yourself! Ugh! Seriously, if I have to spend another 10 fucking minutes.
Yeah.
Hey Johnny, you still there? You've been quiet as hell.
Johnny. Get your gun.
Oh god, damn it.
Damn it all to hell. Damn it all to hell and back with a fucking rusty jam covered pogo stick.
If this goes any further, I might play a different game. Cause I'm not progressing in Final Fantasy VII until I have fucking Yuffie.
What other games you got?
I just downloaded Spider-Man 1 for PS1 and Castlevania Symphony of Night.
Symphony of Night? It's Symphony of the Night.
I don't give a shit. I never played the game. I just heard it was awesome as hell, so I decided, okay, I'll download it. But I'm kind of in the mood to play Spider-Man, though, because I haven't played that in years. It's one of my childhood favorites.
I actually popped in Here Comes the Pain.
I don't even know that one.
Now it's WWE.
Wait, what is it?
It's WWE.
Oh, okay, I never played those games.
Yeah, well, what's it called, the match that I have next is Kurt Angle versus Brock Lesnar. My very first fucking match.
match ever. I remember when Stone Cold was the shit back in elementary school.
he was a bomb, dude.
Him and Triple H or whatever, and who the fuck else?
Shawn Michaels was one.
Yeah, there's another.
The Rock. The Rock.
Ah, The Rock, eh. Nah. I was never really into wrestling. I think The Rock I didn't even know about at the time when I was in elementary school.
Well, which one? He does movies now, so.
Yeah, I know. But she should probably just stick with, because he is getting better at acting.
he's getting better. Man.
Yep, he's getting better. He's not Schwarzenegger levels of bad. Or Sylvester Stallone.
Very.
Batista was very huge here. Batista? I think I know that name. Feel like I do.
Yeah, Batista, yeah. He's a wrestler, so.
Yeah, I think I'll know his face, but his name sounds familiar. But then again, I could just be talking out my ass and not know who he is at all. Just sounds like a cool name that I would know.
But Batista's Drac, whatever his name is, from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, that dude? Okay, yeah, I had no idea who the fuck that was then. For some reason, that name sounded familiar. Seriously, Cloud, you piece of shit. Did you really have to die? No, run. I don't want to use Tifa's limit. Run!
It's Cloud. He's an emo douche. What did you expect?
I'm just so sick of everyone dying. I keep using Phoenix Downs all because I can't find this stupid cunt. You know what? I'm restarting the emulator again. I feel like I'm fucked. Just reset it. Just fuck my life. God. For the love that it all is holy, please.
For the love of all that is holy, stop it.
I'm about halfway through the stream already. Like, I don't plan on streaming as long as I did yesterday. So it's like, come on, I wanted to progress here.
How long was your stream yesterday?
Yesterday was about 4 hours.
Huh.
The first day I've streamed for a good 8 hours. Not straight, but yeah, pretty damn close. And then sadly, because I streamed so much, I guess I couldn't sleep. So like, I had only like 2 hours of sleep at all yesterday. So I was like fucking tired.
Yeah, that sounds about right for friggin' streaming.
Cause I usually don't ever like go for that long. That's the first time I ever streamed that, like that. In general, I never streamed games before, so yeah, this is all first time for me.
Yeah, well, what's it called? My first time I streamed on the Xbox One. Yeah, it wasn't too, didn't have too good of a time, because, it's very difficult to stream because you don't know how people are going to react around you when, when you do stream, etc. Or, like, if anybody will follow you or any of that, bollocks.
Well, here's what you want to do. If you, like, for example, I got 6 followers in the last 2 days, which surprises the hell out of me, but, what you have to do is, like, pretty much promote your shit. Put up a live stream video on YouTube saying, hey, I'm live streaming right now, blah, 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 and then maybe you'll get people from there. Put it on Facebook, Twitter, etc., and, eventually people will come. If no one does...
Cheap plug?
Yeah, cheap plugs, but, hey, that's how the world works. So, yeah, basically just do that.
It works on cheap plugs?
I don't fucking know about cheap plugs. I thought you said cheap plugs, like, doing your own promotion.
I said cheap plugs. I said what? So the world runs on cheap plugs?
Yep, basically. Gotta advertise your shit. Everyone does. Plus, streaming is just funner than recording in general. Getting to interact with the people, and then all on top of that, because I never play fucking RPGs on camera or anything like that. So that the fact that I'm actually able just to go through it, doesn't matter how long I take, it's a live stream. it's kind of the point.
It did take you fucking 3 years to finish Kingdom Hearts 1.5, if my memory is correct.
No. Kingdom Hearts 2 took me, 2 Final Mix took me 3 years to finish. Yep.
Was that just being lazy, or was that just like,
Nah, see, I found her! I found this bitch! Fucking finally! With Kingdom Hearts 2, it was kind of up and down. Like, there were times where I didn't have the disc anymore. Like, this time, for example, when I moved here to Brazil, I didn't have the disc anymore. Before that was basically the idea because of my camera, it took 2 hours until my batteries died, right? Which, what the fuck's 2 hours? How do you progress a game in 2 hours? An RPG? You don't. you fucking don't. I mean, look how long it took me just to get fucking Yuffie here. You don't progress with the shit. It took me a fucking hour. And so, it's like,
Fucking Sonic 06 had like 8 hours and it didn't progress worth shit.
Oh, it doesn't progress anything. The entire game, there's no progression. Got 16 hours. I think it took me like 16 hours to beat that fucking game. God, what a waste. But,
that's 16 hours of my life I'll never get back. Thanks, Sonic Team.
Because for me, progressing in an RPG, because 2 hours doesn't feel like any kind of progression. In any other kind of game, you have that feeling of progression. You're getting through what story there is. And RPGs is like, oh, yeah, I just got past one segment. You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
RPGs takes forever. So, especially now since, fuck you, person outside, get the fuck out of here. That's loud as shit. Whatchamacallit. So yeah, not until I moved here, and got my new computer, that's when I was able to actually play the rest of the game, because I was able to actually, emulate the game, since I could download the ROM and shit like that, so... Yeah, that made it, that's how I was able to actually finish the fucking game. To emulate it. Without this computer, it would never be finished.
Yeah. Well, then again, that's kind of the thing with certain games, when it's like, you stop playing them after a while, or you lose the disc. It's like, damn, do I want to play that game again? But then it's like, son of a bitch, I can't find the fucking disc.
Yeah, because for me, like, I own the original Kingdom Hearts 2 game. But I never owned the Final Mix version, so I had to actually burn it. So I had a burnt English patched version of the game. So, but when I moved here, I guess I forgot to pack it, so I don't have it anymore. So what I had to, I just had to deal with not having it. So yeah, that's what ended up sucking. But when I got this computer, I was like, okay, I downloaded it, I translated it with the new English patch, which is like pretty much 100% done. Got that, and I just emulated the shit out of it. Like, the PS2 emulator is hard for me to fucking run. I can't even run Simpsons Hidden Run. That shit fucking lags like hell. So it surprised the hell out of me that I was actually able to sit down and play all of Kingdom Hearts 2 without any lag, pretty much. The only time it lagged really bad was during the Axel battle in that. And that was it.
Yeah, well, then again, Axel's kind of a cheap prick in general from what I remember of Kingdom Hearts, so...
Well, he's not a... Like his first battle's not bad. It's just, the whatchamacallit. In Kingdom Hearts 2 Phenomics, they have these, extra boss fights, the data forms, and they're hard as hell. And, in that one, I wouldn't be able to fight Axel in that battle because it would lag so much because in that battle, he has the lava, field attack going on the entire time, and that's what lags the hell out of the game. I guess there's so much going on when he uses that attack that the emulator just can't work on my computer.
Hmm.
Well, now I'm getting Yuffie's fucking dumbass. Taking out my iPod right here. I got the instructions. Getting Yuffie. Okay. Not interested.
Huh. Yeah, which one? I mean, the Final Fantasy games are very, especially ones like 7 are just really fucking weird.
Yeah, they're not bad though. I feel like they improved
not,
all along the way.
Not bad. They're, I'm not saying they're bad. I'm just saying they're weird.
Like weird in what way?
Like just like how the mechanics are compared to like the earlier and the later, especially with 7, how the you know it's. Kind of feels different to the other Final Fantasy games.
Well, it's also because like this is their first attempt at an actual 3D version, so they wanted to see how far out they can actually go with this. But yeah, it's actually pretty impressive if you think about it. For a first attempt, this game came out really fucking good for what it was. I just don't agree that like it's the best one out of all of them because I feel like they improved as they went on. So Final Fantasy IX is the definitive Final Fantasy game on the PS1. Not counting Final Fantasy VI because I never played that one, so I would have no idea. But, yeah. Fucking A, my fucking throat's sore as hell.
Eh. You're probably better off getting a drink of water.
Yep, exactly what I did. I'm Yuffie, good to meet you, blah blah blah. Oh, wait, so now the bitch is with me? Fucking finally! God, fuck this cunt. I don't care how old she is, she's a bitch.
Well, God. Again, she is a little girl, so little girls, you know.
Oh my god, finally.
The world is their oyster.
So yeah, she's level 17. Let's see. What's your worth? At least her... all her stuff has, like, 3 materia places that I can put shit, so... If I didn't want to put anything on her, I could.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Her strength is pretty good. Fatalities. Meh, it's alright.
Just be curious, what does fatality do you know?
I think that has, like, something to do with, like, your health. But I'm not sure. That's what I know vitality as, in other games that use it.
What is, like, durability for your health or whatnot?
Maybe it's, like a way of defense, I guess. Because there is no... Well, there is a defense, actually, here, so I'm wrong on that, apparently. Yeah, I'm definitely not the person to ask these questions to. I got no answers.
Yeah, I'm with you. So somebody asked me about RPGs, like what? The New World.
Like yeah, you know, I don't even think luck of as anything. Like the whole critical hit thing. Yeah, I had no idea. Just to let you know, I'm gonna try not to swear anymore. Good job, Advanced. Should definitely try to you know stay clean. Go to church. That always helped me. Totally.
Well, fuck.
You wanna know one of my first church going experiences were when I went to this one church, right? And I had Yu-Gi-Oh cards back when they were like the shit. And I brought it to the church and I had the pastor come up to me and he's like, "These are made from the devil, blah 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 blah. Put them away, I'll throw them away, blah 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 blah." And I remember me crying about that shit to my mom. I was like, I was fucking young as shit, and this motherfucker comes up to me talking about how my shit's from the devil. Like, what the fuck? And that he was gonna throw. But I wasn't crying because of that. I was crying because he's
fucking cards.
Yeah, exactly.
The damn card game.
I wasn't crying because they're the devil or anything. I don't give a shit about that. What I cried about was the fact that he threatened to throw him away. I was like, he's gonna throw my shit away. Fuck that guy.
Yeah, but
I never really had a good church-going experience, ever. I'm not a church-going person. Mm-hmm. I'm one of those people that's like, if you believe in God, just fucking talk to a wall while talking to him. He'll hear you. You don't need church for that shit. Don't give me that. Mm-hmm. Church is everywhere. I mean, God is everywhere, motherfucker. But even when it comes to me, I don't give a shit about religion anymore in general. I had so much of that shit last year, I'm just about ready to puke it. Tired.
Well, what you call it? With me, I'm still Christian. Like, I don't go to church. Like, I still believe in religion, but I don't go to church as much as, you know, like I used to, so.
Yeah, I'll probably never go to church in my own free will. Like, 2014 is one of my worst years, because that's when my dad really became a fucking fanatic. To the point where he kept saying he was seeing shit. And at one point, because he never ate, he always went with, God will feed me, bullshit like that. To the point where when he was driving at one point, my mom was with him. Good thing, too, because he was basically unconscious the entire fucking time. Like, think sleepwalking, but sleep driving. Yeah.
What?
Yeah, no fucking lie. Like, every time my mom said something, he would look at her and, like, with a blank stare, like he was looking through her. And, the gas was running out, right? Gas is running out. And, what ended up going on with that was, gas runs out, because he goes to a gas station to fill up before the gas runs out. And, when my mom says, there's a gas station here, let's go to the gas station. He looks at her, and when he parks, then he just drives off. Like, he still just drives. He doesn't even stop at the fucking gas station. And, so with that, they go, they keep driving to the middle of nowhere, and then the gas runs out. Then my dad parks it aside before that, and then goes out, knees down on the dirt, starts fucking crying with the Bible on his lap. This guy, he is so fucking exhausted and out of his mind at this point that he's praying, hoping there'll be gas in the car. And, like, my mom, like, called up a family that we have and was like, I don't know what the fuck to do with him. He is not listening to me. It's like, I'm not even here. Please come and fucking pick me up or get some gas, something, please, because we're stuck here. And so, yeah. So they had to go there. My mom got picked up. A friend drove my dad's car after putting some gas in, and they took my dad to their place and had him sleep there. So that's how bad my fucking dad was with that. Yeah, like, he was out of his mind there, like, delusional at that point.
Well, then again, you also told me that he also tried to attack you. So.
Oh yeah. Yep, that's the thing.
I don't want to open up that can of worms.
Yeah, I'd rather just forget that ever happened. Okay, I'm still live streaming probably for a little bit. I'm gonna end the stream then continue a new one in just a second with Spider-Man in the actual thing. So I'm gonna be playing some Spider-Man. So let's open that shit up. Hopefully the ROM fucking runs. Actually, I didn't test it.
Do you ever test your shit? Dare I ask?
No, I'm pretty much spitballing here. Okay, so let's test it. Is it working? Show me the Neversoft logo.
Remember when that was a thing?
Yeah, before fucking it got trashed.
Before what got trashed?
Neversoft got trashed. It's not around anymore. That development team was disbanded.
Was
okay, now we're on to Spider-Man.